I think it is fitting to give, yes, honor to those who have been a blessing to us. This corps has been blessed in many ways. Yes, by the influence of people who have been here, have participated, have given of themselves to share with others. This certainly was the case with Brian. He was a giving man. I remember one of the first conversations that I had with our bandmaster, who was not here and would love to be here to share this with you, how he met Brian. He was actually, our bandmaster was ringing the bell, and a person walked by and conversed with him and mentioned that he was a Salvationist. And so, of course, he was invited to participate here, to come and to worship with us. And as they came, he happened to mention that he played in the band. And so, of course, our bandmaster immediately opened that opportunity for them to come and to share, even if it were to play something. Not knowing that who was sitting in our band was a former Canadian staff bandmaster. Well, when that became known, immediately was put in the first row. Again, just telling how his humble spirit, the way Brian came across, not trying to draw attention to himself, but to the Lord.
Yeah.
And again, how that spoke volumes to all of us. Well, I will read some words that our bandmaster shared to share with you on this day. It was a blessed privilege to have bandmaster Brian Burditt as part of the Conway Corps Musical Forces. Brian was willing to play first or second cornet. He would help and direct it. He would play at the Christmas tree lighting during our time at the kettles, at the sunrise service, and he enjoyed tutoring even one of our own life. We all liked hearing him and the stories that he had, his many experiences, not only as a bandsman, a bandmaster, but as traveling the world in Salvation Army ministry.
Yes.
This is from our bandmaster. He says, I will always remember the email that I received from Brian from Tanzania. He wrote, Dear bandmaster, I brought my cornet mouthpiece with me so that I could buzz daily and keep my lips in shape. Ruby and I feel very bad that we're not here present to share this special tribute to Brian, God's special bandmaster and friend. Amen. His memory will always live in our midst, in our hearts.
Yes.
I share a verse from Psalms chapter 108. The very first verse says this, My heart is steadfast, O God. I will sing and make music with all my soul. This verse truly reflects the life of Brian. He made music with all his soul.
Amen.
We are grateful that Susan, his loving friend and wife, and others who are here to share in this fellowship. May God bless you all. May God bless his family. And may God bless the Salvation Army.
Amen.
We are grateful that she's also shared with us a video that we're going to see, a bit of pictures and some of the events that took place in his life.
Thank you.
life has been how he devoted himself to others, and particularly to young people, particularly to those young musicians. So the South Shore Army Corps, Conway, has established for this division the Brian Burditt Scholarship. To be able to afford at least one young person every year the opportunity to attend the music camp here in the division. To be able to further their not only musical development, but of course their deep knowledge of the Lord. And I want to read what was written for this recognition. For his outstanding service to the Conway Corps, in particular, for his indelible effect on the band, the Conway Corps is proud to sponsor young people who desire to further their musical development, named in honor of bandmaster Brian Burditt, who exemplified love for all mankind and devoted his life to selfless service. The Salvation Army has been impacted worldwide by his dedication, his encouragement of young musicians, and to inspire all who encountered him. He was truly a man after God's own heart. And we're going to keep this. I'm just going to show you here. We're going to keep this here. I have another one that I'm going to share with the family, but we're going to keep this here as a reminder, again, of the ministry of this great man and how much, again, he impacted not only us here, but again, in Salvation Army all around the world. Let me ask you to bow with me in prayer. Father, many of us would say, as the poet wrote, how can I serve thee better, Lord? And we would respond, I have not much to give thee, Lord, but all that I have is thine. Yeah. Father, we are grateful that, yes, one of your servants was amongst us. And how wonderfully exemplified that spirit of service, of giving of himself to others, that others would not see only himself, but the Lord, even loving for him. Father, we thank you that you have, yes, blessed us and inspired us through his ministry. And we ask that we would be able to continue with that ministry, that we would be able in some way to serve someone else, to inspire them, to encourage them. Father, we even pray now for the young people who will have the opportunity to, yes, further develop their musical skills, yes, that as Brian showed us and taught us, it is more about the notes on the page. Father, we thank you that, yes, we can trust on you to continue to bless us. And we pray that you would, even today, as we're here gathered, we ask all this in the name of Jesus.